Hey, everybody. Good morning. Good afternoon. Good evening. How is everybody doing? My name is Jeff Gellman of Solid Canine Training. I'm telling you that because a lot of people take these Facebook Lives and they actually share them. So if you don't know who we are, we're based in Providence, Rhode Island, and we've got a great board and train facility here. And what we do is we specialize in aggressive rehab and behavior modification, but we deal with young dogs. We start dogs, little puppies, off with clicker and food. We start actually a lot of dogs off with clicker and food. We do on-leash and off-leash obedience. Go to our website, solidcaninetraining.com, and you'll learn more about us. I personally travel the world doing dog training seminars. Christopher, I hope to see you and your wife down in South Carolina. If you didn't get tickets yet, please let me know. Now what I want to do is we're just going to show the intake video of this dog. We work with all dogs. A lot of people see big dogs. We work with little dogs too. This is a Pomeranian. So here we go. This is the intake. And this dog just does this nonstop. Okay, I know it's just a little bit of barking there. Now show the walking around video. So this dog, they can't take this dog anywhere. They live in New York City. They can't take this dog. They cannot take this dog on the subway. They can't walk this dog down the street. They can't take this dog anywhere in public at all.
Usually when we see other dogs, we walk the other way.
So all this dog, imagine this in New York City nonstop, everywhere. People, dogs, everywhere. Typical stuff we see all the time. Okay? All right? All right. Now, show it with the staff. Now, the staff walks it around just to show that it does the same thing with the staff. This dog was just dropped off like an hour ago. Maybe it's been about an hour and a half now. Okay? Now, this is John with the dog. Same nonsense with John. You know? Same nonsense with John. All right? Okay. Now we bonk the dog. Show the dog now with the staff walking the dog around after being bonked. That's the same dog. All right. And now let's show the dog right now. This was a 5 to 10 minute process. Okay. So, and let's get these dogs closer. Same dog. So bonking is a very effective way to punish an unwanted behavior. So look at the dog now. We bring the dog over here. So this little guy is not afraid of our trainers. It's not afraid of me, and I didn't do anything, I'm just the camera person. It's not afraid of anything. Don't ask it to do anything, I just wanna see it walk around, please. I just wanna see it walk around. Let it make its own decisions. Okay. We do this all, now the dog is not off, you know, the dog's not off leash trained yet, the dog's not even on leash trained yet, that's not the point. The point is, if you want to stop an unwanted, we actually have the bonking. We're going to edit the bonking. We're going to include it in a video. We're going to make a video of how we spent the first 5 minutes with this dog. Dog is fine. This concept that if you punish a dog, it'll be afraid of the handler, or it'll be afraid of other dogs, or if it'll be afraid of, like, you know, people, it's a lie. It's an outright blatant lie. Punishment is powerful. No, John bonked him. And if you don't know what a bonker is, here's my bonker. Here's a bonker. This is the bonker. It's a cotton towel, right? It's a cotton towel. It's wrapped up, and you say the word no. So you want to mark it with no, and then you throw the towel at the dog. The dog does not get hurt at all. The dog is fine. Okay? They can't take this dog anywhere. They can't take it on a bus. They can't take it on a subway. They can't take it on an airplane. They can't take it out to eat. They can't take it anywhere at all because of its behavior. I can't stress enough that it's so important that we understand there is a proper way to punish, okay? Proper way to punish. Bonking is easy. Bonking is easy. Here, Jess, hold the camera for me. Can you see me? Okay, so I'm walking a dog. I'm not gonna bonk any of these dogs because they don't warrant bonking. That would be mean. So there's a dog right next to me acting like a total jerk. All right, I say no, Did you see that as they throw it down?
That's how you bonk. It's as simple as that. Guys, it's simpler than teaching the dog to sit.
You missed it, do it again. You have to watch the replay. Watch the replay, all right?
Yeah.
All right. It was too small and you didn't do it hard enough, Jonathan. Yeah, don't do a corgi with a washcloth wrong size. You want to do this. Now, that's not the only thing we're going to do here, but remember, if you
need to do, you bonk it at them. You hit the dog you're not hitting the dog with your hand. You're hitting the dog with the bonker. You won't hurt the dog. It's a towel. You know, I talk about this all the time, and we get so, this, if you guys are going to be mean down below, I'm just going to delete you because this is the thing. So many families are struggling, and for 99 cents, they can stop the nonsense behavior. Now, that doesn't mean the dog is trained, but all of these outbursts could be stopped. All of them can be stopped. Can you bonk out in public? That's up to you. You know, but you don't need to. Bonk in private and then take your dog out in public. You know, Kathy, what I want you to do, and I'm not trying to be snarky here, I want you to figure it out for yourself. I'm not trying to be rude or disrespectful. What I'm trying people to do when it comes to dog training is realize it's not as difficult as people think. If you want a dog to do more of something, you reward it. If you want a dog to do less of something, you punish it. Okay? That's dog training in a nutshell. That's dog training in a nutshell. So this dog now is walking around all happily, all right? Got it? That's how, now this dog gets to get trained. Okay? Now this dog gets to get trained. That's it. Now we get to work with the dog. Okay, that's it. That's my Facebook Live, all right? That's my Facebook Live, all right? So for a proper punisher, you want it to hit the dog. You're not going to hurt the dog. Guys, it's a cotton towel. You will not hurt your dog. No, you can do it on an abused dog. Guys, you're not being abusive. Please, 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 please understand. We do this all the time. It doesn't make a difference if the dog has a history of abuse. And also, most people hear the dog is abused, but they have no proof that the dog was abused. Okay? It doesn't matter. You have to punish for unwanted behavior. If you don't punish for unwanted behavior, you will never get the dog to stop. Or you'll be struggling for months or weeks when it can be fixed very, very quickly. Yes, bonk the puppy for biting at the feet. Yes. Guys, it's a towel. Please, 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 let's scale this. We need to really think logically, and we need to scale this. So, dogs, what they do is, think about this, a dog is biting you. A dog is biting your child. Why are we not worried about that? Right? Why are we not worried about that? Why are we not worried about our children being bit? Why are we not worried about our dogs biting us? Why are we not worried about the dog pulling us down the street and harming us? Why are we not worried about all these other behaviors and all we are is worried about is the dog? I'm more concerned about the human. I'm more concerned about this couple who can't enjoy their life with their dog. That's my number one priority. That's my number one priority. The dog will do fine. The dog's going to do fine. We have to start being more human-centric. Let's start being more human-centric. Got it? The dog will be fine. The dog will be fine. All right. Love you guys. I got to go. I got to head to the gym. You know, my personal trainer. I got to go there. All right. Take care, guys. Bye-bye.